In one of the most historic cities in America, two teams from New England will battle in Philadelphia for the championship of the NCAA Division II East Region. Joshua comes out of the pack with the rebound. Quick angle pass in transition. Braley scores, the third most accurate shooter in the conference. Very speedy guard. Drives, has a lane, lays it up and in with the left hand, and we're all even.
For him.
St. A's playing tough perimeter defense. Here's Cumstone. A turnaround on the baseline is nothing but that, and the Skyhawks have their first lead. Joshua with 7 on the shot clock, into the paint, finger roll good. The defense broke down at the last second. Teams here. St. A's 2 years ago was in the regional championship game. Taggart with a tough jumper, rattles in. Talk about the friendly roll. Hit the back iron, went straight up in the air and found the bottom of the net. Logan's got it mid-post where he likes it, backing it on Taggart. Turnaround, one-handed flip, and it's good. We can be a good defensive team, he said, if we do what we're supposed to do. A poke away and a steal for Joshua, and he takes it the whole way for the layup. Bess, who's back into the ballgame, back into Logan. He works spin move and a beauty. He got it around Grant McKay, who's into the game for the first time, the Scotsman. Fortin started as a freshman early in his career. Now as a sophomore, comes off the bench. Bess a three for the lead, and it's good. Isaiah Bess with 5 quick points. A bounce entry in traffic to Gears. And now going to the hole for the slam is McKay. And St. A's back on top by 1. Cumstone, top of the key. Now to Smith, a three for the lead. That's good. I can see it's going to be one of those types of games, an any 10 backyard brawl in the city of brotherly love. Cody Ball quick to the hole, and he gets the favorable roll. Here's Cody Ball, splitting defenders. Beautiful finger roll layup, and St. A's back on top. Shot clock now into single digits. Smith looking to create. 3 from straight on over Fortin, and he buries it. His shot off the rim from the angle. Rebound put back, no good by McKay. Cumstone had the rebound, lost it to Gears. That's the second time Gears has come away with a loose one, and it results in a Taggart 3 from straight on to tie the score. The freshman of the year in the Northeast 10 Conference. Here's a 3 for the lead by Logan. That's good. Ryan Logan now with 9 points. Into the paint, gets it back out to Gears. Gears, a driving pump shot, good off glass and a foul. And game clock down to 5 now. A kick out, Heiliger a 3 for the lead, it's good! And that'll end the half. Taggart jab steps, now drives baseline, wide open, scores the layup, and now St. A's is back on top of the seesaw.
Nice layup by Chris Braley.
He scored the Hawks' first 6 points, and a beautiful move by Isaiah Bess in traffic, slingshotting it in. McKay, a 3-pointer for the lead, that's good!
The flows of this game are just amazing.
Ball gets stripped and Cumstone comes away with it. It's a 3-on-2 break for Stonehill. Scoop layup, Carter Smith ties the game.
Mike McKay.
Hey, you think that 3-pointer might have gotten him off, but hasn't looked comfortable. Here's a step back 3, good by Bramante, and the Skyhawks are back on top. They've scored 8 unanswered. Now a lob into Braley, a spin move and a beauty, and he banks it in to give the Hawks the lead. Whips a pass out, Bramante a 3 to tie, no good. Cumstone rips down the board. Now Carter Smith, thought about the 3, kicks it out. Cumstone, a triple to tie. It's good! And being face guarded by Gears. Here's a 3 for the lead, Logan. It's good!
In Harrison Taggart's face with that.
Joshua retreating, now starting his dribble. Here's a 3-pointer in the left corner. Braley, it's good! Chris Braley with the knockdown. Carter Smith drives, layup, good! And just like he did against Southern New Hampshire, did it very quickly. 8 seconds to play, Joshua drives, puts the shot up. No good, tapped up, also off the mark. Logan's got it, 2 seconds to play, 3-quarter court heave. It's just off the backboard, and we're going overtime again. Logan reels it in, throws a pass that's a little wobbly out to Bess, who pump fakes, drives inside, lays it up and in. This is the second time in 3 games that this as Taggart hits a go-ahead 3. 3 now puts his Hawks ahead. Logan backing into his man, and he saw the double, he backs it in. His team leading, as we see a layup by St. A's to tie the game. Smith drives. He has another layup, and he puts it in.
It's amazing, the hesitation dribble.
St. A's needs a couple of 3s. Gears takes one of them. No good. Rebound by Bess, and that'll do it. The Stonehill Skyhawks, the fourth seeded team, knocks off second seeded Saint Anselm and will go to their third Elite Eight in the last 11 years.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Just that easy. A victorious Stonehill Skyhawk team, and you become the first player, the first assistant coach, and the first head coach in East Region history to win a regional for the same school. How do you feel?
It's pretty amazing. That group of guys over there just couldn't be happier, more proud of them, and it's a special, special group, and this is awesome.
So where would you be without Carter Smith? You talk about big players step up in big situations. He wants the ball in his hands down the stretch.
Yeah, he does. He's just been fantastic, and just he's turned himself into one of the top point guards in the country, and he's just fantastic. Just a great, great kid and a great player.
I know it's a team effort. It's almost hard to point out guys, but the combination, how skillfully of passing the basketball, Ryan Logan, when he get it in the post and it's not there, so smart finding guys and then reposting up down low.
Yeah, I mean, it's something that we worked on going into the playoff tournament, and it worked really well. Just it's tough with the shooters and then Ryan inside. So I'm going to go with my guys.
Yeah, one last one. Have you ever been to Frisco, Texas?
We will soon.
You are going. Guys, very excited. Chris Krause going to celebrate with his Skyhawks. They are the champions of the 16 East Regional. All right, thanks very much, guys. Carter, have you ever been to Frisco, Texas? I hear it's lovely this time of year.
I've never been to Texas, but I'm happy to be going.
So I talked to your coach, and it's something we talked about a lot, of having a point guard that wants the ball in his hands, can get to the rack, can hit a shot, and can distribute. Did all that tonight.
I appreciate that. I mean, he has faith in me, but everything I do comes from my faith in God and my faith in each other, the teammates, the faith we have in each other, just everyone down the line, the faith we have in one another is why we're able to do that.
So every time you hit a shot, free throw, whatever, you touch your chest and point up. Can you tell me when that started and what it means to you?
It kind of started last year. It just means that's why I play. I play for God. I play for Jesus. I play for the opportunity. I know this game is special to me, and I'm appreciative of it. I'm appreciative of the opportunity, being around such great guys, such great coaches. And I don't want that to be missed by people. And so I just want people to know that I'm very appreciative of that.
You said last year, or this year, that last year you weren't quite sure what to expect in the NCAA tournament, and that this year you're going to be more prepared for the atmosphere and everything involved with it. Obviously, last year got you to this year, and this year you're going to Frisco. Congratulations.
Appreciate it. Yep. We are thankful. We're ready to go.
And it's Frisco, Texas, not San Francisco, so don't get lost on the way. Carter, thanks so much. You're looking at him, who is the most outstanding player of the 2016 East Regional.